NASA uses nuclear batteries to provide electricity for many planetary science missions. One small, simple type of radioisotope power system that is extremely versatile is known as a radioisotope heater unit, or RHU. Without any moving parts, an RHU passively radiates about 1 watt of heat. When placed carefully aboard a spacecraft or inside a rover, the heat energy from RHUs serves to keep a mission's hardware at proper operating temperatures, compensating for the very cold temperatures often encountered in space exploration. RHUs have a rich history of use on NASA missions. They were first used with the science experiments that were left on the surface of the moon in 1969 by the Apollo 11 astronauts. Soon after, the early RHUs were headed to deep space aboard NASA's two Pioneer probes in 1972. Pioneer 10 was the first spacecraft to fly by Jupiter. The two Pioneer missions survived 30 years and 22 years in space, respectively. Later on, NASA's Galileo mission to Jupiter used 120 RHUs to keep its spacecraft components warm. The Cassini mission to Saturn used 117 RHUs, including some on its probe called Huygens that was dropped into the atmosphere of the hazy moon Titan. The heat from its RHUs helped the probe survive all the way to Titan's icy surface. RHUs have also been a valuable part of Mars exploration, too, oftentimes on spacecraft that are primarily solar-powered. They played key roles in helping keep the systems on Mars rovers such as Sojourner, Spirit, and Opportunity working properly despite the cold winters and nightly frigid temperatures on the surface of the red planet. All told, the United States has flown 300 RHUs on space missions. The heat source for an RHU is a pellet of plutonium dioxide about the size of a pencil eraser, contained within several layers of protective material. The current generation of RHUs are called lightweight RHUs after they were redesigned in the late 1970s with increased safety features. These new features include a ceramic form of plutonium dioxide, improved metal alloy cladding around the heat source material, and better insulation to make RHUs less likely to release any radioactivity in the event of an accident. About the size of a C-cell battery, an RHU has a mass of 0.08 pounds or 40 grams and is about 1.25 inches tall by about 1 inch in diameter or 3 centimeters by 2.2 centimeters. Because they are a steady source of dependable heat, RHUs contribute further to mission success by helping to reduce the need for a spacecraft to spend some of its precious electricity running electrically powered heaters. This can reduce design complexity and save a significant amount of power that can be used instead for other hardware or scientific instruments. Eliminating electrical heaters also reduces the chance that electromagnetic interference from them can damage the quality of scientific measurements. The United States Department of Energy has a healthy supply of RHUs available for use on future NASA missions. Thanks to recent work, there is plenty of plutonium dioxide heat source available, as well as supporting materials for the aeroshells and insulation needed to make more RHUs, should NASA ramp up its forecast of future mission concepts that could need them. And recent changes to the U.S. national space policy have made it more efficient to obtain the federal approvals necessary to launch nuclear power systems like RHUs. NASA and DOE have developed a framework that would allow proposed space missions to use up to 130 RHUs on a spacecraft without requiring a specific mission-focused nuclear safety study as part of their environmental reviews. Such missions would still need approval by the NASA administrator. So, the next time you hear about some of the historic NASA missions powered by radioisotope thermoelectric generators and their major contributions to our understanding of the solar system, give a thought to their frequent, equally silent partner, the radioisotope heater unit.